I, just like all the other cellists in the world, hate Pachelbel's Canon in D. The universal wedding procession tune was written in the 1600s with an accompanying gigue, just to lie dormant and forgotten for hundreds of years until it was resurrected by Jean-François Paliard's Chamber Orchestra in 1968. My name is Dr. Dominique Royam, and I'm a music director, conductor, and music communicator, here to help you achieve a deeper connection to the music you love. Follow me on social media at Dominique Royam for more content. Let's talk about the rise and eventual hatred for this iconic work. Musicologists differ, but most agree that Canon in D was written sometime around 1680 to 1706 by German Baroque composer, organist, and teacher Johann Pachelbel. During his lifetime, Pachelbel wrote over 500 works for different types of Baroque ensembles and for organ. He held a number of prestigious positions as an organist in churches in German-speaking Europe during his lifetime. He also taught a number of prominent composers of the next generation, including Johann Sebastian Bach's older brother Johann Christoph Bach. Pachelbel was well connected with the Bach family and attended the wedding of the same older brother in 1694. Pachelbel's music was widely imitated, becoming the model for South and Central Germany during his lifetime. Pachelbel's style was clear and uncomplicated, focusing on melodic and harmonic clarity. His music is less virtuosic and harmonically adventurous than German Baroque compatriot Friedrich Buxtehude, though they both experimented with different types of ensembles and instrumental combinations. Pachelbel was known for his variation forms, which can be seen in the Canon in D. The eponymous Canon in D is a canon, a musical work that is based on a number of instrumental voices playing the same music, offset by some amount of time. Another type of canon is a round, like Row, Row, Row Your Boat, but a canon does not have to be identical music for all parts, all the way through, like a round. Pachelbel paired the compositional technique of the round with ground bass, or an independent bass part that is repeated over and over again, also called an ostinato. In Europe of the 17th century, works that incorporated ground bass and variations of treble voices were sometimes called chaconnes or passacaglias, terms that are also associated with Canon in D. The ground bass establishes the chord progression of the work, which turns out to be a sequential pattern known as a romanesca. This romanesca pattern of 1-5-6-3-4-1-4-5 lines up with the first two bars of the canon, D, A, B, F sharp, G, D, G, A. Here's that ground bass now. You can see the chords being played by their Roman numerals under the bar. During the work, onto the ground bass, the violins come in one by one with two measure themes. These themes stack on top of one another and finish out the harmonies outlined by the ground bass. This piecemeal composition is why Canon in D is so good for a processional. The work can stop at the end of any two-bar ground bass with just a simple addition of a tonic chord. It can be as long or as short as it needs to be. Let's see that in action now. Each new two-bar theme will be a different color. So why do I hate it? that ground-based ostinato chaconne construction. It forces the lowest voice of the group. For a wedding, it's primarily the cello of the string quartet to play the same 8 notes over and over and over again until the end of the work. The other members of the ensemble get to indulge in increasingly complex melodies on top of the ground bass, but that ground bass never changes. That's the point of a ground bass. It never changes. The work is incredibly boring for the cellist. When the work is played by a single instrument, like the organ or a piano, the instrumentalist gets to play all of the variations of theme along with the ground bass. The ground bass moves from voice to voice when it's played on a keyboard, not so in a string quartet. So how did a work written in the middle Baroque become the wedding song? The work was first published in 1919 in an article about Pachelbel's chamber works by Gustav Beckmann. In 1968, the Jean-François Paliard Chamber Orchestra recorded a version for an LP by Arato Records. It romanticized the work, introducing the slow and stately tempo, which is now endemic to performances. In 1970, a San Francisco classical station played the recording and was inundated by listener requests. In 1974, London Records reissued a 1961 album that had a recording of Pachelbel's Canon on it, thanks to the increased demand. The retitled album, Pachelbel's Canon, the record that made it famous and other Baroque favorites, was the highest-selling classical album of 1976. 1977 saw RCA Red Label reissue the original Paliard recording in the US and elsewhere. It was the 6th highest selling classical album of 1977. We have the wedding of Prince Charles and Princess Diana in 1981 to thank for the popularization of Canon in D as a wedding processional. In their fairy tale wedding, the couple used a different Baroque processional, Prince of Denmark's March by Jeremiah Clarke. This use of Baroque music in an internationally televised grand wedding soon brought imitators and focused a lot of attention on Baroque processionals. The popularity of the Canon in D in the classical world soon led to it being used in many weddings around the world. Nowadays, I suggest anything else but the Canon in D for a wedding processional. A good string quartet can play any number of modern hits in the style of a classical string quartet, so I suggest picking your favorite. Don't torture your cellist with those 8 notes of infamy. Choose something else instead. Thank you for joining me in this lighthearted look at Pachelbel's Canon in D. If you want to hear another lighthearted take on Pachelbel's Canon in D, check out Rob Pavlonian's video, Pachelbel Rant. It's linked in the description. Like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more. What do you want to learn about next? Leave me a comment down below. You can also support the making of these videos on Patreon. These videos take over 20 hours of research to complete, so Patreon is a great way to show your support. The bibliography for this video can be found on my website, DominiqueRoyam.com. Interested in seeing my process? I document it on social media, so follow me for more updates. My handles are listed below. Thanks again, and see you in my next video.